Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Rob's Theme Park Vlogs, where I'm here at the Chessington World of Adventures Resort for their Wilderfest summer event here. It's a nice hot day on park. Good to get back to this event. I came to it last year, and it had a really, really good lineup of shows. Rides availability was really, really good, and the park was really nicely decorated last year, so looking forward to doing this again this year. Loads of stuff coming up on the vlog today. We're going to be catching loads of rides in the middle of the summer. Going to be going and doing, seeing some of the shows around the park area, and generally having a really good day. I'm joined by Rachel and Elliot for today's vlog.
Hello.
It's going to be a good day. We're going to start off with a ride on Mandrill Mayhem, make our way down there, make that our first ride of the day. Welcome to the vlog, here we go. So down at the mini stage, you've got a nice selection of shows going on. You've got the Coco Melon show and Giggles and Games with the Gruffalo. I've always said there's a really good selection of shows and stuff here at Chessington, and the mini stage is kind of more the stage for like the younger families and stuff like that. So like, when you've got young kids and stuff, that's what they use that stage for most of the time. But really nice to see sort of shows running there. When I came earlier this year, I don't think they actually had shows running on that stage at the time. I think it was kind of under a bit of a refurb, but so they've nice to see that they've got shows back on that now. No, looking very good indeed so far. So there's construction work taking place around what used to be the old reptile house here. This used to be where the scare maze was when I did last year, which was the creepy caves unearthed. It looks like they're doing a lot of work around here, to be fair. So that's literally where you went in there last year. We went through that gate, down the stairs and into the reptile house. There's work going on around there though, so we could potentially be seeing a new scare maze. I remember them saying last year actually that it was the last year that Creepy Caves was actually going to be running. So definitely going to be something new coming this year, and no actual announcement as to what is coming yet. So do watch this space for updates on that. Right then, time to enter the world of Jumanji for a ride on Mandrill Mayhem. So just come off a ride on Mandrill Mayhem, and Rachel's added another coaster to her list of coasters. It's ever expanding, Rachel. She was terrified on it, to be fair, but she did a really good job on it. She's done really well. Rachel's trying out new rides all the time here now. Like, she's literally, you know, getting on more and more stuff all the time. Really good ride on Mandrill. It's always a good ride here. I think it's a brilliant addition to the park. And another one for Rachel. Basically, what we're basically doing is we're basically hyping Rachel up for Disney and like Florida.
The better it'll be, that's the thing.
No, she's doing well. Another ride added to the list, ever expanding. Last video we did when she was in Taunton Tower, she did Galactica as well, so adding more and more rides every single trip. I told you it wasn't, I did say it was smoother. No, really good. I think next we're gonna head over to the Wild Woods now. Take a ride on Vampire, so we'll see you when we get down there. Right then, time for a ride on Vampire. Just got a good ride on Vampire there. Tell you what, it's really warm today here on park. Definitely got sun cream on today. Don't want to be getting sunburn. nice to come to a park when it's actually a hot day. I might actually do Tiger Rock today. I think it's definitely warm enough to. And DJ Sharky this year has got his own major stage. So DJ Sharky has been at Wilderfest for the last few years now at the park. Mainly he's been like the sort of warm-up act prior to the show, and sort of does like a little bit on the stage in between the day and is part of the headliner show. This year he's got his own full-on stage, complete with lighting and everything. Really, really good setup here. Looks pretty good, doesn't it? I'll turn around again for you, hang on. So this is DJ Sharky's DJ stage. And you've got shows running here today, 11 o'clock, 12:30, 2:30 and 4:30. Obviously, I guess these show times are kind of set in stone, but as I always say, do make sure you keep an eye on the website and on the app for the latest show times on a daily basis, as I guess they can sometimes be subject to change. But no, the next show here is at 12:30, so we'll try and catch that, or maybe the 2:30 show, but I'll make sure I do catch some of that for you today. Right, we're over here at the main stage. We're about to catch the Who Headlines You Decide show.
To move ahead, got the boss, we'll see.
Some highlights there from the Wilderfest You Decide Who Headlines show, returning again for this year. It was very good last year, and I think it's even better this year actually. They had some new acts this year, new competition. The stage show itself is still the same sort of format, so there's three performers. You decide at the end who headlines the show at the end. It's kind of like sort of X Factor meets Animals, I guess you could say. But no, really, really good show. Some new effects in it this year. I noticed we've got some new lighting on the stage compared to last year's show. Still got the spark effects, still got the smoke and all the sort of that kind of effects that's always been there. But no, some new lighting in the show, new songs, and a really, really good mix of songs. If they had a bit of older songs in there, mix of new stuff, really, really good sort of lineup. No, thoroughly enjoyed that show. Later on, we'll be catching the show of DJ Sharky's live stage show. That's over at Adventure Point, so we're going to see that a little bit later on. But now it's time for some more rides here at Chessington.
So just inside the indoor queue for Toon Blaster. Looks like they've done some real good work in here. They've got all the lighting back working. They've put some new gels in the lights. I think they've actually replaced them with LED, actually, so they should be much longer lasting. Got a much more deeper sort of blue colour over there. That was very dark over there before, so they've actually redone that. And as you can hear as well, I mentioned last time I came here, the soundtrack's actually working inside now, so that wasn't working for a long while. Nice to see them doing some actual little improvements here and there around the areas. Much better. Even here in the station, the lighting's been updated as well, so they put new lights in the ceiling up here, replaced the flickering candles that used to be, and the lighting that used to be off before prior to the dispatch is now permanently on as well. It makes the station a lot brighter than it was before. I'm not sure really how I feel about that. I think I preferred it when it was darker, actually. It made it a lot more eerie, but I guess it's for dispatching and so the operators can see the bars properly and stuff.
So I've just come off a ride on Toon Blaster. There's been a lot of changes in the ride since the last time I came. Mainly it's been a lot of lighting changes in there. So as you saw from the little previous little clips I just did a minute ago, in the actual internal queue line, the lighting's been updated in there and it looks much better, actually, I'd say. Station, they've made it a lot brighter now. They've taken like the little LED candles that they used to have in there, they've taken them and just put standard light bulbs in, which made it a lot brighter. And that has kind of continued into the ride itself, which I think is a bit of a downside to the ride now. You remember a few years back they did what was like an LED UV overhaul, where they basically just put really bright UV lights in every single scene and it basically lit up everything, including like what you're not supposed to see, like the mechanisms and the hidden parts on the walls and stuff like that. So I feel like it's kind of gone back to what it was like a few years ago, where in some scenes the lighting is better than it used to be. Like actually in the Anubis statue scene, the skulls are really well lit up in there now than they never used to be. But in some of the scenes, it's kind of got worse again, I'd say. But the ride itself is still really, really good. I just think LED UV works okay, but it has to be done correctly. And I think it's not as good as it used to be. Normally, I'm not very critical of light rides, but when it comes to like lighting, it's obviously something I do in my everyday thing. When I see it's not done quite right, I think it could be done better. But hopefully that's just a sort of temporary thing at the moment, whilst they might do some more stuff over winter to make it a bit more focused. Obviously they haven't really got time in the season whilst the ride's operating, but we shall see. But good ride nonetheless though. Waited about 45 minutes for it, so it's quite busy on part today, as it's going to be. It's the middle of summer, so it is going to be busy. But no, apart from that, good ride. Well, there's something you don't see every day on a vlog. People getting evacuated from a ride. The little river raft ride's just gone down here at Chessington and they're getting evacuated. Right, rare credit
coming
for them.
Backwards.
Rare credit for them guys there. Yeah, you don't see that every day, do you?
This one first.
Speaking of river raft, we're going to go on a water ride now. We're going to go around and do Tiger Rock. Let's head that way. Oh, look. The tortoise is going to fix it. He's on the repair job. A nice refreshing way to cool off there. I think you got wetter than me actually on that one.
Yeah.
So Elle took the brunt of the soaky bits there. Good ride on Tiger Rock though, nice on these hotter days to get on some of the water rides. At least, I think most of the parks have still got at least one water ride in them where you do get semi-wet. Obviously Fort Park has got Tidal Wave, you've got Tiger Rock here. Drayton Manor has got Storm Force 10, which you do get soaked on. And of course Blackpool Pleasure Beach has got Valhalla. So you've got quite a few parks that have still got water rides in them. And on days like this, you do really appreciate them. Not sure where we're heading next yet, but I'm sure you'll find out in a few seconds. Right, we've come back down to the world of Jumanji. And do a few more rides on Mandrill Mayhem.
Third time, fourth time.
Gonna be good.
Yeah.
It's not the most of my favourite ride here, I think, now. I mean, definitely go on here plenty of times when I come here. We'll see you when we come off. Another ride on Mandrill Mayhem down here at the World of Jumanji, and hopefully we'll be able to get back on it again before the day is out. So we've got Rachel's got her ride access pass, so we're going to go and do Gruffalo now, and then we'll come back down to here before the day's out, I think. So we'll see you down at Gruffalo. Right, we've made a drastic change of plans. We're going actually going to go over to Dragon's Fury.
Spot appeared, didn't it?
Yeah, so with the ride access pass, because you have to book them like when they become available, the same as virtual queuing, we've been trying to get an access pass point for Dragon's Fury all day, and one's finally become available, so we're going to go and do that because we haven't done it yet, so we're going to do that now. We'll head over there and see you over at Dragon's Fury. Highlights there from the DJ Sharky show. Really good show actually, quite a nice sort of fun atmosphere around Adventure Point. I'd say it's very similar to the flash mobs that they've had in the past, but more centralized on a sort of main stage in the middle of Adventure Point, so it makes it a little bit more central to the area. Last time when they had the stage in the corner, it kind of separated a bit, but I think from what they've been doing over the last few events where they've had it for Halloween last year, Mardi Gras earlier this year, and now for the Summer Fun Wilderfest event as well. That sort of central stage, I think, is going to become a sort of more permanent thing over the next few events, as I think it works much better in the centre of Adventure Point rather than off to one side. No, really good show indeed, though. Nice and fun and exciting. Anyway, we've kind of knee-wrapped our day up here at Chessington now. Done quite a few rides, haven't we, today? We managed to get on most stuff because it was a busier day. I say my sister's ride access pass does help. And as mentioned, if you are a disability and stuff, then I highly recommend you getting the ride access pass, as it means you haven't got to wait in the queues long and stuff. It's much better, you know, especially if you can't stand in the queues for a long time, so I highly recommend that. But no, that's kind of the end of our day here now. It's been a very good day, seeing a lot of the Wilderfest stuff, a lot of the shows. Really, really good event this year. I say it's going to keep getting stronger and stronger as each year goes on. They're going to add more and more bits to it. I say this year they've not had as many as the live musicians as they did in the past, but I'm sure they had that for Mardi Gras, so maybe they're trying to sort of separate the events out a little bit and not make them too much the same, otherwise it does become a bit repetitive. But we'll see what they'll have for Oktoberfest and for Halloween here. I'm going to try and get to both of them events, and I'm going to try and get myself down to Fort Park for Carnival before that comes to the end as well. So that may be potentially the next video that comes up on the channel. But for me, Rob, I'm Elliot here, and Rachel,
bye!
We'll see you next time on Rob's Theme Park Vlogs. Take care, everybody.